So this will be the history optional orientation for the Trivandrum and the Bangalore batches. Trivandrum and the Bangalore batches. So let's start the orientation. So history optional. The one thing is that what I would like to say is that it is one of the safest options. One of the safest. I'm not saying that this is the most safe. There is nothing called any most safe optional. There are few options which are called the safest. History, sociology, anthropology, geography to an extent. Then there's literature subjects. These all we can say that the safest optional. History is also one of the safest option. Reason is that you will get a minimum assured marks. See, you know, our optional paper is for 500 marks. And the toppers used to get around 280 plus. This is the optional winner's marks, 280 plus. And anything between 260 to 300 is a good mark. And very few will get above 300 marks for any optional. You may have mentioned some optional winners with the 340 out of 500 for some subject, but that is for only one or two person. It's not for all. History, the topper goes up to 339. Okay, history topper used to get 339, but that never means all the history students will get that mark. But 280 plus or up to 300 is a good mark. And the toppers, usually one or two or a handful, may cross 320, 330 marks. But unlike many other subjects where our shockers are there, the advantage of history is that history, whatever was, you will be get something around 250 and you can go up to 300. That is a good mark of the history, 250 to 300. On the other hand, many other subjects, sometimes it may go up to 330. Sometimes that may go down up to 150 also. As I am taking one optional subject, and it won't be good to comment which options are like this. I don't name that options, but you can Google it. You can search for the options and you will get the points. So history in any condition, it's an all weather road, we can say. That is, history will give you minimum assured marks. Even if the questions are twisted or difficult or whatever it is, minimum assured guaranteed marks will be there for the history optional. On the other hand, other options, not all options provide this safe net. So that is one advantage of the history. Then the second thing is that many will have the doubt that, sir, whether the history option is scoring. And recent times, the problem of history is that we won't get the toppers, the first two, three, four, five ranks, history optional. Nowadays, we are not getting big winners in that section. Once again, let me adjust that meeting settings. I know the option is okay. One second. So that, okay. So toppers are not there for the last 5, 6, 7 years. We didn't get any first rank, second rank, third rank, fourth rank, fifth rank. But still every year, almost around 100 students clear with history optional. So getting into civil service with the first rank or 50th rank, you will be in IAS, or 200 rank, you will be in IPS. The idea is that you have to get into the service. So every year, almost 10% of the students clear with history option. So every year, nearly 100 students, they clear with this subject. Okay, 100 students, they clear with this subject. So among that, out of 1,000 or 800 students, 100 is not a bad number. It's a good number. So this much number of students clear with this. Then the third thing is that the scoring, that I will show with the marks of my students. Just a moment. See, these are my winners in the 2018, year 2018. See, it shows that 2017, because that year in which you write the prelims, that is considered as the year. This is the results that came out in 2018. Then 2019, 2020, I will show that. This is the results, six winners of mine, six students who got into the services that year. See the marks, 276, 286, 286, and that's my name, Shobhan George, in the top, 280, 286, and 1255. See the marks of my students. They are getting almost the same marks. These are the winners. That year, many students went for interview. They didn't clear, but their history marks was good. I will show that marks also. Even though they got good marks in history, but they couldn't clear the interview. Otherwise, the list would have been more. Okay. So average 10, 12 students of mine write the mains every year because you have to clear the prelims. That's not in my hands. Optional comes into the picture during the mains examination only. During the mains examination only. So 12 students used to write and average 6 used to get into the services. And those who are not clearing, they are not missing because history marks is bad. So the point here I am saying is that my students almost get the same marks. That shows that they are following the same strategy. 3 students who got into service got the same marks, 286. And that's very good marks, 286. Then 1280 and 276 and 1255. These all are my optional students. And this is why I have the confidence that it's proven results. My students who are writing the mains are getting good marks. So I know the strategy to teach the history optional. So I am not going to boast about that in any other way. So this is just for giving you the confidence. I can prove, and these are the winners who are into the service. See, this is the mark of Parth Gupta. He is also my student, history optional student, Parth Gupta. 2018, his paper. See the history optional mark of Parth Gupta. He got good marks. See, 275. But he didn't clear. See, not recommended. Because his GS marks were not up to that high. So he was not able to clear that in 2018. But the same year, Mohammed Junaid with the 276 became an IAS officer. Mohammed Shabir with the 255 became an IFS officer. But Parth Gupta, even though he scored 275, he didn't clear. Because I want to show that all my students who are writing the mains examination are getting good marks. But for some reason, they were not able to clear the exam. So this was in 2018. Now let me show the result of 2019. This is Parth Gupta 2019. Now, this year he cracked the examination and he scored still 269 for history optional. And in the year 2019, there was an average 20 marks less for all the option subjects. That's why Parth came down to 269, or else it would have been a 290. If we take with the scale of 2018, that was around 290, but still he cleared with in the next year. So 2019, Parth Gupta cleared. Now in IRS IT service. So history optional students are there. They are getting good marks. See, no need to worry about that. These students are like you people. They are in a position to get into the service with history optional. Plenty more results to show, but this is enough. Okay. So history optional is scoring. Is there any advantage for taking history optional? That I will say. There are certain advantages for history optionals. First thing is that our syllabus is ancient India, medieval India, modern India, and world history. These are the 4 topics of our syllabus, which is divided into 2. That is paper 1 and paper 2. This is our optional history paper. And ancient India, medieval India, modern and world history. This is for optionals. Even if you take history optional or not, you have to study this modern India and world history for GS mains. So that means even if you take history optional or not, you have to study this GS mains. Modern India world history. So that is 50% of the syllabus you have to study, whether you take history optional or not. Then art and culture is mainly from ancient and medieval. So 20% of that syllabus also you have to study. So first point is that even if you don't study history optional, you take geography, sociology or whatever, still you have to study 70% of history optional for your general studies preparation. So those students who take history optional, they need not study anything separate for GS. That time you can utilize for other subjects. So you will get more time if you take history as your option. And the second thing, every year, 16 to 22 questions will be from history for the prelims examination. That means almost 20% of the exam. Out of 100 questions, every year 16 to 22 questions are from history. No subject guarantees this much questions in the prelims. For example, polity questions may range from 4 to 24. Sometime polity questions came down to 4. That is, the constitution questions came down to 4. Or sometimes it can go up to 24. Geography can be come down to 11 to 16 questions. Recent trends, last 2-3 years trends, I am saying. This is how the other subjects are there. So this 16 to 22 is very crucial in clearing the prelims examination. And those who are taking history as your optional, you can have a cakewalk in these questions. You will have a definite advantage than other students in this 16 to 22. So this is the two advantages of the history. One thing, you will get more time to prepare for other subjects. Plus, you will get more marks in this GS for prelims as well as the mains. Because mains paper one, you have history and world history and art and culture. Definitely, you will score marks. Plus, your time will be saved. That is another advantage of history option. So these are the topics which I would like to say. Then one more thing. Facts and figures. See, history, mains and prelims is entirely different. See, today morning we studied many things. That was for prelims. On the other hand, the mains examination, that is optional examination, is entirely different. Prelims is facts based. Here you have to study the names, terms, years, so many things. But that no one can save you, because preliminary is for all the students and general studies history is factual oriented for prelims. So whether you take history optional or not, you have to study facts there. But on the other hand, mains is analytical. It is analysis. Why this happened? What were the consequences? How this could have been avoided? Was the decision of Mahatma Gandhi to link Khilafat did good for the national movement? There you are giving only analysis. Believe me, you are writing the mains optional answers in history without mentioning any name or year. Very rarely you need to mention any year or any name in the optional history, because optional is not the remembrance of the crude facts. Optional is clear-cut writing, and it is the beautiful analysis. You might have seen this news reports and TV shows where they give the analysis of the events. Here, you are analytical. You are just like an advocate argumenting in the court. Why this happened? How this could have been avoided? What if this was not included there? That way, it is analytical things. Okay, that's an analytical thing. I would like to give this orientation. Just I am giving you the guarantee of history optional. Where I am teaching, I can give you that guarantee that you will not be thrown out of UPSC rank because of history. That's I can guarantee. See, if anyone takes history optional under me, your history optional marks will be very good. That's my guarantee. Only thing is that you just follow what I say. That's it. Other than that, nothing else. I give the notes. Okay, I give you the notes. So your work is almost reduced by 90%. You are not going and searching big books and making the notes. I will give you the notes and just study that notes and try to improve that writing. You will get marks. This is the guarantee I can give, because I have the results with me from 2013 onwards. First year, my result was in 2013. And my first optional student who cleared is Hari Krishna Pai from Kerala. He is now the Kalimpong district police chief in West Bengal. Since 2013, every year I have the results. Okay, and last year it was one Nidhin Kunneparambal and Rishu Priya and one Angel. Three results last year. Last year only three results. And this year we are waiting for that. This year only six students are going for interview. Because we want students to clear the prelims. That's it. Only few students. See, every year there are so many students attending the class, but very few are clearing the prelims. That's why the results are not that big. If the history option students, If they could manage the prelims, they could have scored better in the mains. But very few are writing the mains. This is for all the subjects, okay? So, no need to worry that you are going to study fact, figure, a year and all, nothing. Mains answer is analytical. Clearly analysis. It is pure analysis. Nothing like what we studied today in the morning for that Indus Valley thing. Okay, Indus Valley, we were saying about the factual things only. But mains entire thing is different. What's your opinion regarding the origin of Indus Valley civilization? There we will give the theories like that. So it is theories. Then one more thing. Many used to say that history optional is vast and other options are not that vast. See, one thing is that ancient India history syllabus is well explained. For example, I will give an example. Indus Valley civilization. Indus Valley civilization. In the UPSC syllabus, it is mentioned as date, explained as date, origin, urban features, trade, art and culture, religion, decline, survival, and continuity. This is a problem created by UPSC. Had UPSC just mentioned Indus Valley civilization, the syllabus would have been very small. Instead of that, every topic of history is detailed explanation is there in the syllabus. This makes history the well-explained syllabus of UPSC. It may take 5 pages also if you download the syllabus. But if you take some other subjects A or B, just 2 pages will be the syllabus. So my advice is that don't measure the syllabus with the scale. History, if they just mentioned Indus Valley civilization, that would have been over with the 3 words. Instead, by explaining that, they added some 10-15 words more. So every topic like that, automatically, the syllabus will be watched. Advantage is that they had given us the clear idea that what to study and what not to study. If it was simply Indus Valley, we would have studied more. But now by making it explained, we know what to study and what not to study. That's the difference of this. On the other hand, some other subjects may give the syllabus like this. Political thinkers and thought. Just 3 words only. And you see Indus Valley civilization, that is bigger. But here the political thinkers starts from Plato, Aristotle, Socrates, Machiavelli, Chanakya, Karl Marx, and modern thinkers. Some 10, 20 thinkers, their theories, thought. By the time you finish this module in that option, we will finish 1/4 of the syllabus. So don't think that history optional is vast. This is not that vast. On the other hand, literature subject. Assume that literature subject gives the mention of some books. Say, for example, Mahabharata. They mention Mahabharata. They only 1 word is the syllabus. But can you finish Mahabharata just like a 1 word? There are some 23 books you will study in options. Short stories, novels, poems, new poems, all the poems, essays, like that. Entire book you have to read and you have to comprehend everything related to that. So literature subjects is more vast than history. By the time you finish one book, Khazagan Itihasam in Malayalam, or Girish Karnad's work in Kannada, or some other writer's work in Tamil, by that time history optional half will be over. So don't think that history optional is vast. It's not that vast. History is vast, but UPSC history optional is not vast. We have a well-defined syllabus. And with good faculties, it's not that difficult. It's good faculties. I don't know about the faculties everywhere, but some can complicate the syllabus. Some can make it more easier. That depends on the faculties. So this is what I would like to say about history optional. And the rest is that if you are interested, you can attend 1 or 2 sessions when we start history option. And this is what I personally prefer. I don't know whether, I think the demo is allowed. You can ask for demo session before joining. You may attend 1 or 2 session. You attend the session and if you feel comfortable, then you join. I don't want to forcefully join. I don't want to force anyone to join the optional classes under me. If you have confidence, you can join, no problem. If you are still having the lack of confidence, please attend few sessions and then decide. If it is good for you, you join. And if you are not able to follow that, okay, you leave. No problem, no guilt feeling, nothing is there. So this is what I would like to say about the history option. And if you have any specific doubts, you can ask. We have two timings that has actually 5:30 to 8 weekdays, or else 9 to 1 in the weekends. These are the two times. So what is comfortable for all, we will stick to that. 9 to 1 weekend means almost 8 hours per week. And this is almost 12 hours or 12.5 hours per week. No much difference is there. 1 month may be increased in the weekend class, that's all. Sir, I am from Trichy. Is I am eligible to take a course under you? You just consult with your sender head. They will give you the answer. I'm not sure about that. You can just ask with your sender head. You can ask for that. Maybe the regional centers, I don't know. Maybe you may have the option to join. You can just ask. Sir, since the paper is static, all answers will be the same. No, that's a wrong impression. History optional is not at all static. It depends on the answer, because once I take the class, and tomorrow I make give a test, even the 100 students write the answer, the 100 answers will be different. It depends on the individual analysis and writing. Only the points will be the same. The way of presentation will be different. That is individually. And this advantage is there. Staticness is having one advantage. Assume that you got a question called the Quit India Movement. It's an indirect question. Assume that you are having little doubt in writing that question. But still you studied something on Quit India, you won't be blank. You will be in a position to write something. Instead of getting a very good answer, very good mark is 6 out of 10. Okay, you basically use 60% for the best answer. Instead of getting 6 out of 10, you can manage 5 out of 10, even in the difficult questions also under history. But some other dynamic subjects, if the question is twisted, you cannot write that answer with your knowledge. So that's the advantage of history offer. Whatever asked, even if you don't know that directly, still you will be in a position to write something. So that is one of the advantages of the history subject. That's okay. 5:30 class, if your option GS is getting over by that time, we can shift that to 5:45 also. Even if you are attending, see, those students are attending this GS classes, you will have two GS classes per day. So attending optional in the evening may make you exhausted. So it's better to prefer weekend batches, because so that you can fully focus on the optional on that day. Otherwise, you will be a bit tired also. Earlier, when it was offline, I used to take weekend only, so that the students were very happy also. Last year online, I took this 5:30, and this issue was there. Teacher is sometimes exhausted. Today, I'm a bit exhausted. 11 o'clock class, 2:30 class, 5:30 class. And this will be for you people also. Sometimes you will have 11 o'clock, 2:30 class. Then attending optional, you will feel tired. So it depends. Let's say once this admission formalities are finished, let's have another talk when to have the class, evening or the weekends. We can discuss about that later. I can guarantee that history optional is safe, no doubt in that. You may attend other demo sessions and you can attend other classes also. You ask for one session for attending sociology, one session geography, or one session history. You attend that, it's your freedom. But personally, I will allow my students, because this is very crucial. Optional subject is very crucial. Don't forcefully join one option, or don't think that, okay, my friend is joining this option, let me join. Nothing like that. If you have confidence in your teacher, you can. And we have 1 week, one entire week of class, I think, for this Trivandrum Bangalore centers. 1 week I am having this GS this week. So attend all the sessions, you will get a feel of history. That's what I would like to see. So that's regarding my optionals. Any other doubts? Now, those who are listening to this, you may attend the GS classes and demo sessions and then take a decision. So we will see in the optional class. Okay, that's all. Bye.